No matter what you ask, I have but one answer, whispered to me by my ancestors. Because we are the people of the land. Because we are the keepers of her stories passed down to us from the olive trees. Because her rivers run through our bodies, and our grandmothers embroidered her landscape on our skin since 10,000 years. Because we saddled her first horses, we sang her first ballads, and we harvested her wheat with love no matter who held guns over us. Because our poetry watered her gardens since before she was Canaan. Because we danced when she married the Mediterranean Sea, and we made her wedding cake, a tray of kanafe from Nablus. Because we were always there. We are the Jews and the Christians and the Muslims. We lived, converted between religions, settled from pilgrims, left and returned, mixed with our conquerors, died by their swords, and nourished her soil with our bodies. But we never left. But we never left. But we never left. When Henry VIII sent Anne Boleyn to the Tower, we were in Palestine. When Marie Antoinette was marched to the guillotine, we were in Palestine. When Galileo gazed at the heavens, we were in Palestine. When Columbus got lost, pillaged, and raped where he landed, we were in Palestine. When Queen Nzinga ruled the kingdoms of Ndongo and Matamba, when Genghis Khan broke through China's Great Wall, when the suffragettes marched, when all of your history, it was us who were there. Not in Europe or Russia or Poland or Brooklyn or Yemen or Iran or Iraq, but in Palestine, continuously for millennia. Because we created her dances. We terraced all her hills and nestled our homes in her grooves. Because we slept, ate, gave birth, married, loved, aged, and died in her arms since time was fitted for a calendar. Because now she's under a foreigner's boot, her curves decapitated by urban planners, her trees cut and burned by their hate, her body scarred and siphoned dry, her pomegranate owned and caged, her za'atar buried in concrete, and her wild, tumultuous history violently stuffed into a plastic box branded with a new name and an epic myth. They've killed her birds, taken our hummus and falafel hostage in a museum they built over the graves of our ancestors. But we know, and only we can tell her native stories, sing her native songs, and dance for her, a promise from her children, determined to make their way back to the embrace of her sun-kissed hills and her orange and olive groves. To revive her desiccated rivers, that they might again roar with life as they did when our family was whole on her banks. We will always write our love letters to her, always sing and paint and sew and cook her favorite foods, and think and fight and cry and plant and harvest and celebrate for her, our Palestine. We lean on each other. We count on our friends and repudiate the normalizers of our oppression. We persist. We exist. We are one nation, one history, one heritage, one people, determined and destined to go home.